Hi everybody, welcome back to Busy Dad's Workshop. Today we're going to talk about string trimmers. I have a Troy-bilt 4-cycle string trimmer here, and over the past few years that I've been using it, I've been having some problems with the string head itself, with the trimmer head. And so I started looking around, finding some solutions that we can do to fix this. And one was to try to rebuild it, and unfortunately I couldn't find the parts for it. And I'll show you what that particular item looks like here shortly. But I went out and actually found a replacement. The Troy-bilts have the Easy Link system, so you can actually connect this right in place. Now, the replacement that I got has these strange blades on them that look like this. It's a nice solution, however, it's expensive. It's almost $10 per packet for these, whereas I can really go out and I can buy for 14 bucks a couple hundred feet of regular string. And so what I'm deciding to do is replace this, after looking online, is replace the actual head with a bump and go easy wind type of head. So what we're going to show you here today is how to not only, you know, repair the string trimmer, but also to modify it so that it works with the bump head. So here's the actual failed part of my old string trimmer head. These are the bump style, where you hit it on the ground and it would let the string come out of the holes here on both sides. The problem with these particular units is that when you had to replace the string, you would have to take this unit out of the head, wind up the string on both spools here, because it used two separate strings, and then hopefully put this back in without having any of this line unspool on itself. So what we're doing is we're replacing that with this unit here. And this is by Shakespeare. I found this at Lowe's when I went to go pick up the replacement string trimmer head. This is a little bit different. It doesn't hold as much line as this does, but it makes it extremely easy to replace. With this, there's this piece right here that when you line it up, there's arrows. When you line these arrows up with the holes here, you actually feed the line right into the head, and then you simply crank it until the line is completely pulled in. And then it works like any other bump head, where you would hit it on the ground, and you can see it has that spring action where it would allow the string to release out. So it makes it a lot easier. So here's the unit that I actually purchased. This is another Troy-bilt item. This is, it's the Aeroflex head. And like I said, it has these rubberized blades that, if you look at them, they kind of look a little bit like airplane wings. So from what I understand, the different colors handle different materials better, like against sidewalks and trees and things like that. But the problem is that once these wear out, you actually have to take apart the head. There are two places to grab onto the head here to pull this off. So it still makes it kind of problematic that you're still having to do a lot of manual labor to deal with replacing these wings. So what we're going to do is replace this head. Now, this particular bar here, this was about $60. This head here is a $20 additional item. However, I think the 20 bucks that I spent on this and the $14 on a couple hundred feet of string are much better than constantly replacing these and buying just a packet of these, $10 at a piece. So I'm going to show you how easy it is to replace this head and put this additional one on. So here's our existing head that uses these winglets for strings. We're going to take that off. It's very easy to do, so all you need is a small screwdriver. And if you see here on the side, there is a gap in the housing. All you have to do is line that up with the gap that's on the housing itself. Stick the screwdriver in there as a placeholder, and then turn it clockwise to release the head. Now you see there's a particular thread setting on this. Now the replacement comes with various adapters for male adapters, if you have a male or female head here, and then different threads for the different makes. This particular unit can work with multiple different manufacturers. Luckily for me, the threaded insert that's here automatically fits right on top of this. So all I need to do is tighten it up, and I'm actually ready to go with this. So that's as simple as it is to replace this. And again, this is a bump head, so you can see it has the spring action. And it's very easy to replace the string again. And here is an example of the spool that's inside. You can see right there is the hole that you feed the string straight through. So you would string this through and then use the outside ring here to just wind it all back up. Now that we have the head reassembled with the new bump head, all we need to do is add the string guard, which it comes with the four Phillips screws. Now that we have our assembled string attachment all completed, all we have to do is put it back into the Troy-bilt string trimmer itself. With the Easy Link, it makes it very easy to be able to do this. With the Easy Link, I can switch this out and actually have a mulcher, have a edge trimmer, or other multiple devices that are available, and just tighten this up, and now it's ready to go back for another season of work. So I hope you learned something here, and if you have any questions, please comment in the box below, and thanks for watching, and happy gardening.